Jambo, jambo bwana, habari gani? Nzuri sana. Wageni mwakaribishwa Kenya yetu, hakuna matata. Jambo, jambo bwana, habari gani? Nzuri sana. Wageni mwakaribishwa Kenya yetu, hakuna matata.
Da mein Flug nach Johannesburg. Die Flugzeit wird heute 10 Stunden 19 Minuten betragen. Bitte vergewissern Sie sich jetzt noch einmal, dass Ihr schweres Handgepäck fast sicher unter Ihrem Fahrersitz verstaut ist und verwenden Sie es auch mit Ihrer Sicherheit, Gurte zu schließen und festzuziehen. Zu Ihrer eigenen Sicherheit empfehlen wir Ihnen, die Gurte während des gesamten Fluges geschlossen zu halten. Außerdem möchten wir Sie noch bitten, Ihre Mobiltelefone jetzt in den Flugmodus zu stellen und natürlich auch andere elektronischen Geräte. Und bitte schauen Sie nach, ob auch die Sendefunktion komplett ausgeschaltet worden ist. Vielen Dank. Die Türe U2L müsste noch umgestellt werden. Danke.
Einige Informationen zum Flug nach Johannesburg geben. bis das Flugzeug die endgültige Parkposition erreicht hat und die Abschaltzeichen ausgeschaltet werden. Öffnen Sie die Staufächer später auch vorsichtig, damit keine Gegenstände herausfallen können.
Rain.
Rain. Oh, yeah. But now, not now.
Ah, but not now. Yeah.
Rain have here in Germany.
But no rain.
No, in Germany we have much rain.
Too much rain.
Yes.
Okay.
But here more sun.
Yeah, rain. Yeah.
One Love African Music TV.
plaisante, ça qu'a chauffé.
Unsere Beef Bites. I have Beef Bites in my back.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You've got
Beef Bites.
Beef Bites. Do you allow Beef Bites?
Me.
Always
yeah. Like me, man.
Okay.
You can touch, but you want to be rough. Wait. No. Naughty. Full of nonsense. Are you naughty, Nunu? If you come from the tail side, you can touch, sir. Do you want to take photos? Come, Nunu. Do you want to sit here now? You're going to fall on your bum. Hold on. You naughty man. Get up there. Okay, guys, now you can come. It's actually better and touch. Take nice photos, okay? Anybody else? Quickly, sir. No. Careful.
It's a wild one.
It's naughty, man. It's okay. Done, everyone. Time up. Thank you very much.
Thank you. That's what feels like. That's what feels like.
Once more. Ist ja süß. Again, please, for the movie. Johannesburg City.
Johannesburg City, and that is Sandton City.
Sandton City.
Oops.
Clarence und and his family. Oh, hier müssen wir mal nachts alleine durchlaufen.
Na, danke schön. Weißt du ja nicht, ob das die Mutter ist.
Natürlich.
Ich bin gay.
Oh ne, no, not hunting.
pick yourself up and dust yourself off and back in the saddle. You're on the front fire, everyone's watching. You know it's serious, we're getting closer, this isn't over. The pressure's on, you feel it.
Said Lufthansa and its budget carrier German Wings dimmed their logo in memory of the 150 people who are presumed to have died in the crash, a mix of people from Spain, Germany, Turkey and other nations, and two of the passengers were only babies. 16 of those on board are believed to be high school children from this school in Halton, Germany, as we reported with our Fred Pleitkin. They were returning home after an exchange in Spain. A candlelit vigil was held today outside their school. For the families, it is a waking nightmare as they wait for their loved ones to eventually return home and to be laid to rest. Imagine a world so many families and friends haunted by the specters of MH370, MH17 and Air Asia. And now this, the deadliest air crash in France in more than three decades. That is it for our program tonight. Remember, you can always see the whole show online at amanpour.com and follow me on Facebook and Twitter.
Oh, yeah. Waterfalls.
Yeah.
Mine here in the Northwest Province, it's called Marikana. Marikana, it was on the news in 2012 where about 44 mine workers were killed by police. What happened is mine workers were on strike, you know, striking for better salaries. So it was unprotected strike. So police came in large numbers, and then mine workers were carrying weapons like assegais guys, arrows, and police started shooting them at the close range. So 44 mine workers were killed in 2012. So after the massacre, it was called the Marikana massacre, the commission of inquiry was established to find out who was fault, maybe the police or the mine workers. So that's what happened in 2012. So South Africa and Zimbabwe produce 97% of platinum in the whole world. There are a lot of platinum mines in Zimbabwe and in this province as well, the Northwest province. So Rustenburg area has got more than 40. Ah, okay, interesting.
There we are now.
All right, welcome to Pilani Park National Park. This is one of the biggest park in the Northwest Province and one of the fourth largest park in South Africa. So the park was established in 1936 and then it started operating in 1979. People who were living here were the locals, the Tswanas. So that's why when driving around the park, you see some graveyard. The park is not part of the sand parks. The sand parks that include, you know, like Kruger National Park, the Table Mountain, Pilanesberg, it's not part of the sand parks. It's owned by the Northwest Tourism Board and also the community. So this is the home of the Big Five. The Big Five, the lion, leopard, buffaloes, rhinos, and elephant. And then the size of the park, it's about 55,000 park, thousand hectares. So it was formed 2,000 million years ago. So it's one of the very, very old park because of the volcanic erupted and then it forms this unique park. So we are gonna drive around the park looking for the animals. There are a lot of antelopes and lots of interesting things to see in the park, like trees, you know, your droppings, spores. So that's basically what we'll be doing right now. So the rules of the park, you're not allowed to feed animals. Littering is prohibited. You're not allowed to go out of the vehicle. And then you're not allowed to take pictures. Just kidding.
Oh. Sorry.
All right, so yeah. Elephant. Yeah, we saw lots of rhinos today, eh? A lot. You can see the warthogs there, eh? Wallowing in the mud. Pumba. That's why we call them baby rhinos sometimes, eh? Because they like to hang around with these animals. Look what he's doing there. So you do see them close to the roads. So there are rare animals such as buffaloes, wild ducks, cheetahs, black rhinos. So those are some of the animals which you don't come across them quite often. But animals like elephant, yes, they are big in size. Rhinos, you know, you do see lions as well. Leopards, But as I'm saying, they are in the natural habitat, so meaning they can, you know, walk around freely. So nothing is guaranteed. So there are antelopes. You see lots of impalas, springbok, zebras, giraffes, you know, wild beasts as well. So there are lots and lots of things to see in the park. So we're gonna drive, I mean, from now, maybe until 1 o'clock, or it depends what we see. So lunch, we're gonna have lunch in Sun City, because Sun City is just around the corner. So that's where you guys are gonna spend the rest of the afternoon.
Woohoo!
Yeah. Rhinoceros. Rhinoceros. Open your windows, huh?
I have seen first.
Good spot. So that's a mom and a calf. White rhinoceros. It's, well, there seems to be quite, I mean, common in. They have one of the longest tongue, about 45 centimeters. Look at that one. You see the colors of these dogs? They're all closed now. So that's a big boy. You can see the thick horns, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Very, very thick horns. They're going to cross. Let me go forward.
Yeah.
I'm sure you heard about Serengeti, you know, where these animals migrate. So we have two species, blue one and the black one, the wild beast. Blue wild beast. All right, something interesting with the monkeys, the vervet monkeys. When they are born, they normally teach them more than 33 different crops of different animals and reptiles as well.
Jetzt hast du endlich deine Affen-Monkeys gesehen. You see, monkeys.
Monkeys are funny.
Yeah, very, very funny. I think it's a good day, you know. You don't see animals like we did.
It's not too hot.
No, maybe. Yeah, you're right. The weather has been good so far. Just to complete cats and we'll go home.
Oh, it's Hans.
So this is a bull. It's a territorial bull.
Ein klein.
You see animal Africa. You see lots and lots of these antelope. Well, as you can see, the females, they don't have horns, and they, I don't see any males around, maybe that side. Males have horns. Impala. So this is the leopard fast food, because we also call them McDonald's.
Weg.
Jetzt lass mich doch auch mal. Bist du fertig?
Nein.
Oh, ich will auch ein Foto davon. Mach mal, Thomas.
Warte, ich mach gerade ein Video.
Trager phalaces species. These are animals with stripes. So they have between 6 and 8 big ears. And then males have very, very large horns, the spiral horns. Kudus are browsers, so they eat leaves.
Big ears.
Very, very big, like my ears.
Schon wieder, der geht andauernd los, man.
Are they black with white stripes or white with black stripes? We have three species: Cape Mountain, Bushley zebra, and the Hardman zebras. So the difference is the stripes pattern. When you look at these ones, the stripes start from the top and connect on the belly, and the other species start from the top and they end on the belly. And this one have three different stripes: white, black, and the brown stripe. So they use stripes as camouflage. Zebra. They hang around in groups where the males or the stallion protect. But the meat is very good. So they normally hang around in group like a family.
Das ist auch zu sonnig zum Fotografieren.
Great. They're eating parasites. Wild beast. Gnu.
Nice animal.
Bild im Ganzen hier.
An any animal.
Wow. So dangerous.
Very, very dangerous. Hippopotamus. So water is the only safe place for them. Because outside, they can't run fast because of their short legs.
Sind das jetzt Hippos, ne?
Ja.
So how long do you think they can hold their breath in the water?
Oh, I don't know.
It's between 5 to 7 minutes, and under stress they can hold up to 11 minutes.
Oh.
So you do see them, you know, sometimes on the bank, enjoying the sun.
Baby. Bequem.
Toll, ist gleich wieder weg.
Ja, aber wenn das mit mehr Einsatz gespielt hätte.
Schatz vom Tag.
Und zack, sind
wir. Der nächste Musik etwas lauter.
Hat er?
Der nächste Musik lauter. Ja.
Yeah, lots. A lot of people.
Charged today?
Yes, I have charged the batteries.
Okay, it's good.
All the night and now it looks good.
Wonderful.
It's full.
Oh, das Blaulicht.
So we're gonna go there, take some pictures, drive around, and then it is a very, very a different place in Johannesburg. So after Hillbrook, we're gonna drive through Braamfontein. Braamfontein, which is the central suburb of Johannesburg, where you find shopping centers, colleges, universities, such as Wits the University of the Witwatersrand. That's where Nelson Mandela studied law. So we're gonna drive through that neighbor, suburb, and then through Mandela Bridge. Mandela Bridge, it's a bridge linking Braamfontein and Newtown. So in Newtown, we'll visit Mary Fitzgerald Square. Mary Fitzgerald, she was one of the first women councillors. Lots and lots of people living here are, you know, unemployed. Some of the most wanted criminals are living here. Nigerians, Ghanaians, Congolese, Zimbabweans, very few local people. So that's why today we call it Lagos. Lagos is one of the, you know, the overcrowded city in Nigeria. So lots and lots of Nigerians are living here today in this neighborhood. And you know, with Nigerians, they are well known of internet scam, prostitution, selling drugs. So this is what is happening here in Hillbrook. So you don't want to get lost here at night, because they will hijack your car, they will rob you, but not during the day. Two days ago, I was doing a tour with this guy from Portugal, a photographic tour. So he was taking pictures of these of the building, which was also very, very interesting.
Well, what a nice place to live.
Not at all, not at all. I mean, the buildings used to be good, but because no one was maintaining them, they all, you know, they all ran down, you see. Most of the buildings. Rent is not very, very expensive, because people who are doing good jobs, they don't want to live here. So they prefer areas which are at least safer than here. Stop raining now.
Yes.
Yes. A little bit. It's better than in the morning.
Yeah, it was too much.
The crime is not sleeping.
You can see, you don't see any white South Africans.
No, only nothing. Black men, only black people.
All black people. But before, lots and lots of white South Africans used to live here. But not anymore.
buy something here?
Yeah, they can, you know, but...
Well, one time only.
But it's...
One time.
It's not good. I have a friend who used to live here. She used to tell me that every morning when she goes to work, she will see a dead person. So there's lots of gangs, you know when there's where there's drugs, there's gangs. So they were always fighting, killing each other like that. You see. So it's a crazy, crazy place. It's crazy, crazy. Oh, bro. An old park station, but this is new town. Looks like they want to build something here. There's lots and lots of development now in Johannesburg. This building here, it's a new shopping center. It's a new shopping center.
One more.
Yeah, busy, busy. Very beautiful, unique. It was built in 2000 and completed in 2003.
Yeah.
Bunny Spike. Go Reef City. $18.96. That's open. There's a lot of controversy around this church, where the pastors are, you know, promising jobs, lots of promises, bring money, and then nothing is delivered at the end of the day. So it's one of the churches which is always under you.
Then we have a shanks of one house.
Baragwana taxi rank. It's more than 2,000 taxis in this station, taking people to different parts of Johannesburg, different townships, and as well as long distance. So people are living a very, very better life, you know, with big shopping center. Like that building you see there, it's a Maponya Mall. So it's one of the, you know, biggest mall in this township, Soweto. So 10, 15 years ago, people used to travel daily to Johannesburg for shopping, you know, but not anymore, because now they have malls in the township. So when you look at that red building there, that's a university of Johannesburg. So with your campus, there's more than 2,500 students studying at the university, and the university is working with the hospital, Baragwana Hospital. You can study engineering, business, accounting, tourism, management courses as well. So it's not the biggest, but you know, it's the one of the university found in this township. So welcome. Right, so we're still in the middle class of the township. What's so interesting about these RDP houses, the Reconstruction Development Program houses, the government gives you the house for free, meaning they automatically you own the land. So if you want to demolish the house, you can demolish the house and build better one of unemployment rate. But there are those who are washing cars, they have like car.
The middle class?
Yeah, but this is a square. This is a square.
Cape Town is 111 years of existence today. We don't have taps. We don't have toilets. They're coming down this road. Can you guess how many houses are here?
Können wir reingehen?
Konrad. You can see on the right, all these houses have solar panels, so that's for warming water, because the electricity is very expensive. You see the big church? The big church? Yeah, that's Regina Mundi Church. It's the biggest Catholic church in Soweto, built in 19... So you don't know much about Tutu? Okay, Tutu was bishop of the Anglican, who played a very big role during the apartheid, uniting South Africa. More potatoes, yeah.
I like potatoes.
Yeah, now every country, you know, we eat different food. And...
Park Town.
Weil keiner mal reinkommt.
A meal for the Pedi people. They will boil it, fried, marinated, grill it, you name it. It is high in proteins and very, very healthy. This is the lunch that we have prepared for you. If you like to take houses, you can feel free to book in, spend the night or the day with the Zulu people. And also, Zulu people have the most respectful way in how they greet. They do it with a handshake and it goes like this. Sawubona, unjani, ngiyaphila. Simply means hello, how are you? I am fine. And now I'm going to ask two volunteers, one lady, one gentleman, to come and greet our chief. People to greet the villagers, can we all say Sanbonani?
Sanbonani!
Yebo!
Yebo!
Iqhiba, this is our main kitchen, the only kitchen that we have in this village. Comfortable Siemens mattress, for we sleep on it. And this is the most important hut in this village, in Ndlunkulu, our ancestral hut. The first hut that is built before any other hut, and also he's talking about the long throwing spear that was used by King Shaka's father, King Senzangakhona. It normally had ostrich feathers right at the edge. So when he threw it to attack, it would create this beautiful sound, pa 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 pa. That's why they named the long throwing spear Isipape, from the sound, of course, pa 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 pa. Ujwala, the traditional, there. Excuse me, to marry a Sotho woman, you need to pay 11 cows plus 2 horses. Oof. Ladies first, they'll be seated on your right hand side. The gentlemen will follow, they'll be seated on your left.
Greetings to everyone.
Yeah, man.
Ja, ne, ha, Vikings, let's have more fire.
Booyaka.
Booyaka. Booyaka. How is the man, Baba Tina? What is the man?
Hops.
No.
What?
I am not.
You are not what?
I am not satisfied.
Ain't sure the problem is.
A big one.
Are you satisfied?
Yeah.
No.
Yes. No. Do you want some more?
Yes.
Or maybe Samsung. Oh, you want Samsung? Samsung. Let's give these people a big, small smile.
Jesus.
Three step on right.
Right.
Three step on left.
Left.
One step forward. Asambe, guys.
Bonajoie. Thank you. We're in the Basutu. We're from the mountain kingdom of Lesotho. And this is how you identify us, Basutu men, by wearing the conical hats. The hats represent a mountain called Tababusihu. Can you all say Tababusihu?
Tababusihu.
Thank you. And the blankets, let me show you that. It is icy cold in Lesotho during winter time. And the boots, our forefathers, they were the first to work in the mines, digging gold and diamonds. Whenever they ask her to bring down the rain or to stop, you will now see the paid men entering inside here, dressed in something interesting.
Thank you.
The dance you saw now together with the ladies, we call it Isikenyani. Can you say Isikenyani?
Isikenyani!
Thank you very much, my lovely friends. Isikenyani is a hunting dance. Who can tell me what do we do after hunting and killing the animal? Country within southern Africa, which is Botswana. Botswana in the Great Kalahari Desert. This place, let's say, is situated in the heartland of the Botswana people. With this dance, we pay a tribute to the lost city of the Botswana people, which is Gadi Twain. Gadi Twain, in its own time, it was bigger than the city of
Cape.
Thank you.
UMzansi kaZulu warfare. Ladies, they play a major role inside the battlefield. Whenever they see that their men are losing the battle, they will enter inside to cover their loved ones. Remember, there is no man who's allowed to raise a weapon against women. With this dance, we are saying that a stepping down of a fool is like a blow to the enemy. And a falling down, that was the enemy. Please give us a round of applause! Ladies and gentlemen, now, thank you very much. This is the end of our dance show. Did you enjoy our dance show?
Yes!
Ready?
Yes!
Can I get
is too cold for anything to live in the water, except one thing.
Is that rain water that comes from outside?
It's rain and the
along the way it looked like he lost his way. His torch was found floating on top of the water. He basically stayed on that dry tunnel hoping that help would come, but help was 3 weeks too late.
So the white is the
stalactite. That's your limestone. But the green is us.
What is it?
This is blue-green algae. See? That is what is actually multiplying that green stuff. That's blue-green algae. It feeds on carbon. So when we have carbon, when we breathe in cave, with our body temperature, related to those that they found in Makapani and Dawoon. On the skull of Mrs. Pless. Now with him, it's believed that when you get to rub and touch his nose, you get to wish for a bit of good luck.
another year. Well, in terms of volume and momentum, a lot of that. We're talking about 7 parties and people saying, well, the speculators and see if they can actually manage. But Bakari Thomas is saying, like what he said at his inauguration, when he came to Bobas, he says he is less arrogant than he used to be. Of course, initially, the reason he wasn't even able to set up a coalition that has gone.
Reginald Tambo, who was the president of the African National Congress, ANC, which is our ruling party. So he became one of the longest state president since Mandela went to prison in 1964. So he became a president in 1967 until 1991. And he died in 1993. So he didn't see or enjoy freedom at all, or democracy. Oliver Tambo, O.R. Tambo. So before, the airport was called Jan Smuts. Jan Smuts was one of the prime minister of South Africa. So after 1994, we changed lots and lots of names, you know, and then the port was one of the places which was changed as well.
Mm-hmm.
So it's very big, very, very big. Because during the World Cup, it was, you know, well, before, I mean, it was upgraded for the event, the World Cup.
Oh, that's one I said. Hallo.
Wieder beim Fressen.